Welcome to part 2 of Beginner's Revit course. Let's continue where we left off. As you can see, it shows us the level 1 floor plan as a translucent reference. We can change this under the underlay heading in the properties section. But it can be left for now, as it might be useful. Let's enter our wall command and start drawing the exterior walls from the 150 cm setback. There is a 50 cm misalignment in this area. When selecting, dragging from the left selects all objects completely enclosed within the selection rectangle, while dragging from the right selects all objects that intersect with the selection rectangle. To correct this, use selection filtering, a useful feature provided by Revit. After selecting all of them, we can see what we have selected in the filter section and adjust which selection we want to keep. To move the selection walls 50 cm, we enter the move command and type 50. We can switch between walls by repeatedly pressing the tab key. Connect the walls on this floor to level 3. Next, we enter the floor command to create the floor. We will correct the overlapping walls in the following steps. To leave a space for the stairs on the floor, we select the location where the stairs will meet the floor using the pick lines tool. If I close the thin lines, you can see the selection more easily. To join these lines, we enter the trim command. Let's create a section line from this area to verify the stair height. 240 cm is a perfect usable height. To hide the section line from this plan view without plating it, right click, select item view, and click on elements. To unhide the hidden section line, click on the reveal hidden elements tool, and then it will appear in red. To bring it back permanently, click on it and select unhide. We can close the level 1 underlay for now. Let's start drawing the interior walls. We can use the align command to extend the wall. Don't forget to change the wall's appearance from the graphic settings again. Type CS to continue from the same wall type. When drawing walls, you can change the drawing direction of the wall using the spacebar. To help us visualize the plan, we can name the rooms. We can use the copy command to move this text to the other rooms. Then we need to customize it. We can move the text using the move command or the arrow keys, just like we can move other objects. This with the toilet. And this with the storage. This floor should be divided into two sections, a children's room and a master bedroom. Let's add a master bathroom and a dressing room into a master bedroom. Copy this wall down and then use the trim command to join it with the existing wall. We can place the names of the rooms, dressing room, and master bathroom. This room has a special toilet for the children's room. The reason these walls appear too long is that we need to set the length before starting the drawing in the wall command. Let's delete this wall using the delete command. After entering the wall command, we only need to set the length once, from the properties panel. To quickly change the type of the other walls, use the match type properties command. You can either select the reference wall and then click on the other walls, or you can select each wall individually and change its type from the properties panel. Now we can place the doors. We can also use different door types from the layout family panel. There are various door types available here. We can choose a sliding door type for the dressing room. Once we specify the desired dimensions and press enter, door will automatically be placed. We can view the building section by opening the section box while in 3D view. Sliding door was a good choice for the dressing room. Let's place the windows. We press the WN and place the children's room windows. Seal height should be 30 centimeters. Adjust the height of the walls that intersect with the floor. After clicking on the wall, you must enter a negative value for the top offset value. A floor thickness of 30 centimeters will be better. We can use the level 1 floor plan as a reference to readjust the level 2 floor. Since this is a single line, trimming one side will require redrawing the line on the other side. Let's use the split command to divide the line into two parts and use the trim command. We can continue with the windows. Full height frosted glass naturally illuminates enclosed spaces like bedrooms, providing a more spacious experience. Change the direction of the door here. For now, we can turn off the section box. This time, let's use the align command to align the windows. You can switch between selections by pressing the tab key after moving the mouse over the point you want to select. Let's create the openings in the level 2 plan. The recently used wall types are displayed below and can be easily accessed. two meters wide is sufficient for these areas. We can make it 4 meters for the master bedroom. We can either draw the storefront horizontally with the same dimensions or take its mirror. To do this, after selecting the object, we can use the mirror draw axis command and draw an axis at a 45 degree angle. If we want it to be an opposite wall, we only need to draw a 90 degree angle from the center this time. When we selecting windows, make sure to select all the panes at once instead of selecting them individually. Adjust the top offset by entering negative value. We can adjust the windows using either the match type properties command or the align command. And now, we have come to the most enjoyable part of the design. We are going to start drawing the main outlines of the villa's facade in the part 3.